Beautiful. We're doing this again. Hold on. That's a little loud, isn't it? I'm sorry. It's Lachlan Cross. It's another Studio 97 performance from the Rec Room at 930 Portage, and we got a bunch of guys from the UK with us today. The music, I'm going to do some quick introductions. We're kind of changing up the format here this afternoon, or actually this evening. Robert Harvey, vocals, guitar, take a bow.
Hello.
Beautiful. We got Adam Nutter just to his left. Adam, we've got Stuart Coleman on bass, and Phil Jordan. You guys are in for a real treat. Feel free to stand up. Let's get the show going. It's the music. They're going to play straight through here.
Thank you. Take a long road and walk it.
She said she'll now
Thank you.
Come on, guys. It's a rock show. Get up. Let's do it. Let's do it. We're going to keep this going. It's the music. Studio 97 on Power 97.
This next song is Jagtune.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks. The people. We'll be right back.
Power 97, Winnipeg's best rock at Studio 97 with the music. We got one more to go, guys. One more to go. Then we're going to take a bit of a break and ask some questions. Think of something if you have a question for the band. Find Ace. We'll get to you. This is the music, Studio 97 on Power 97.
This is too high.
Mountains, mountains.
Power 97 with the music, Studio 97. We need to catch our breaths. We're going to be back with a Q&A in just a bit. That was fantastic, guys.
Cheers. Toilet break, mate. We got a toilet.
What's that?
We got enough time, we got a toilet.
Yes, you do. Cool. Yeah. That corona goes right through you, eh, Ron? We're back. Thank you. It's Lachlan Cross, Power 97, and Studio 97 with the music, and we can't let you go without talking to you guys for a little bit. Rob, you might have to share the mic with the other members if we ask anybody. Get off my mic cord there, buddy. Sorry. Okay, quickly. You know what? This is probably going to be the dumbest question you've heard and the one you're getting sick of the most, but when I first got this disc, it showed up and it landed on my desk, and I'm going, the music, how brilliant is that? And why hasn't anybody called themselves the music? Where did the name come from? I hate to start with a question as stupid as that, but was it a long night with a bong, or?
Well, it's well rehearsed, is this question. We call ourselves music because, you know, I don't think the name's that really important, really. You know, I think what's important is the music, so it kind of made sense.
There we go. Beautiful. Quickly, I was just telling these guys while we were in commercial break that you guys are going to come back and wrap this whole thing up with a bit of a jam that you guys are going to... Yeah, so we're looking forward to that, and that was fantastic. If you guys haven't got the CD yet, make sure you run out and get it. All those tunes you heard are on it. Stuart, I got to ask this. Who's that on your shirt?
That's Rob's brother.
Okay, and why have you got him on the shirt?
I don't know. Well, I saw Rob in pub one other day, and it's quite a funny shirt, so I had to get one.
Where are you guys from?
Leeds, England.
Okay, all right. And a small town in that area?
Yeah, a small village. It's about 10 miles out.
Big news for you guys. You just were recently announced as a second stage headliner for Lollapalooza. What does... Am I off base here? You guys are on Lollapalooza, right?
Yeah, but we didn't know what stage we were doing or whatever, I think. Did we? Did you know?
All right. This question might be totally out of left field then, but what does Lollapalooza mean to you guys as a band compared to festivals like Reading or Reading in Leeds or Tea in the Park, festivals you've done in the past? Does Lollapalooza mean as much to you guys?
I didn't even know it existed until this year when we got asked to do it.
That's what I thought.
No, we'd never heard of it in England. But you know, we've played with Jane's Addiction before, and you know, we really respect them, and they run it, don't they? So I'm sure it can't be all bad if they're in charge.
Yeah, no, it's a very cool festival. It's very highly regarded in North America as well. So you guys will fit in really well. You're gonna have to hand the mic back, Phil, to Rob. I got a quick question for you. On the DVD portion of the CD, I actually managed to figure out how that damn thing worked. Took me all day. But you were talking about the music being more of a celebration than anything. What are you celebrating?
I can't really say life. I guess just that we're so fortunate in what we do, you know, we get to go around the world and play to people, whether it be, you know, in front of 60 people or in front of, 3,000. It's a, you know, very fortunate thing for us. And just to do it with like these three it's about chemistry, you know, and that's worth celebrating on its own, I think. But then if everybody else, you know, is digging it, then, you know, life's about celebrating anyway, I think. You know, why be down and everything? Maybe we'll just have a good time, won't you?
Cool. One of the things that I think is obvious to myself and I think everybody in this room is that you guys have a tremendous amount of chemistry. Do you think you guys could create what you create? Adam? without that chemistry? Adam's picking out the jam.
I don't know. It's like it's a chemistry between us four. So it's like if any one of us four, like wanting the band for any reason, it won't be the same, and it probably won't work. You know, we'd have to start something completely different.
One of the things that amazed me about you guys when I started reading up on you is how old you are. And listen, like, just give us the ages here. How old are you?
I'm 19. Rob's 19, and Stu and Phil are 20. Yeah, it's my birthday tomorrow. Yeah.
Happy birthday.
And it is a couple of days after as well.
That's amazing to have accomplished what you guys have accomplished at this age. And we're just being introduced to you. You guys have been doing this and going hard in the UK and parts of Europe now for, what, 2-3 years now?
Two and a half, yeah. Something like that.
Unbelievable. Absolutely amazing. Have you guys been to Canada much? Just got to finish a swig on a beer there.
Sorry. Yeah, quite a bit, actually, yeah.
What do you think of our fine country here?
It's beautiful. We've not been over to this coast, the west side, before. We've spent quite a bit of time on the east side, like Toronto and, is it Ottawa? Is that how you pronounce it?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's cool over there. You know, it's kind of new for us over here, but I'm sure it'll be cool.
Yeah. Well, hopefully we'll have a better day for you guys after tonight are sticking around and you're doing a show at the Rendezvous, which is sold out, I believe. So if you didn't get tickets, unfortunately, you might have to scalp them. But I didn't say that. Favorite song to play live? I'm going to wrap up here really quick here, guys, and we're going to get into that jam here in a bit.
I think Disco is a favorite.
Everybody in the band agree? The drummer's always on his own.
I'm struggling to play that at the moment, so I hate playing that live. Human.
I gotta say, I love The People. I'm looking forward to playing that as a single here. We're still working to take a long road. Question for how many of you are single?
Just one of us.
Just one? No, no way. Okay, well, this is for you. This is my stupid wrap-up question. If you had a chance to date somebody famous, Stewie, come on, who would it be? Lay it up.
I don't know, there's so many. ish. I don't know, Selma Hayek's pretty nice.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, very nice. Okay, listen, we're going to get into a bit of a jam session here with the boys from the music when the Studio 97 continues. Again, thanks for coming down.
Thanks for having us.
Not a problem. And hopefully you got tickets for the show at the Rendezvous tomorrow. All right, we're just going to do a quick break, and we're back with the music. Thank you guys for coming down. That was amazing.
Thanks, man. All right, it's Fearless Fred, and I'm still outside of the Studio 97 environment. Man, rocking show going on downstairs. I hope you keep listening. They're about to get into a big jam session. But besides that, where are you? I don't see enough cars, and all I see is like Pintos and Ladas. Where's all the cool stuff? The stuff that makes me jealous of your vehicle. That's what I want to see. Get out here, drive by, honk, say hello, give me your girlfriend or hot older sister. I don't care. It's Fearless Fred for Cruise Night on Winnipeg's Best Rock Power 97.
Sorry, guys. We have to put... to put up with Fred there for a minute. We'll be back in just a sec.
This is only the second time we've done this. We did this today. It's number two.
How long? 1 minute? 2 minute? 1 minute. Come on, guys, get up one more time. I can't bear to see you guys sit for a show like this.
I know it feels like moving, please. Feel free to dance.
All right, here we go, guys. Once again, guys, thank you for coming down. Much appreciated. The music from the UK, we're going to wrap this puppy up with a bit of a jam. This is Winnipeg's best rock, Power 97. Let's hear it.
Thank you.